aggressive toward this. This is marijuana. It's a very small amount, but it doesn't take very much of this. It's got a very high odor content. Cocaine and heroin have a very light odor.
He is owned by the Department of Defense. He knows 9 different explosive odors. He can smell 7 explosive and 2 pharmaceutical odors. And like Richard was saying, he does a passive response because you don't want him digging at an explosive. So if you do find a bomb or anything, you definitely don't want your dog trying to bite at it or dig at it. Drugs just sitting there couldn't really kill you.
But I have no idea what kind of dog that like.
We acquired him from the Eastern Park. This is Richard's dog. Its name is Rex.
He's ready to play.
He knows what that thing is for.
He's ready to go. Jay sends it back.
Most dogs you find out on the streets are not going to bite something and hold on. First of all, they're going to try to go behind you and lift you. And they bite a whole bunch of times, just real nip. They use a burlap sack and let them pull on that sack. But we want them to bite and hold on. And when the person quits fighting, they will hold that spot. They won't try to get another spot.
Connecticut, 6 months training involved. and I'm training the dog. There are only 10 of these dogs in the world that are in use right now.
Yeah.
Seven of them, I believe, are on the East Coast, two on the West Coast, and one here in Tulsa. What we do, we when we go to the fire scene, we go out and we'll, outside the fire scene, we'll flake an initial sample. We'll acclimate him, give him a scent, and take him in, and he'll alert on approximately 18 different scents. Gasoline, kerosene, naphtha, diesel, number two fuel oil. The reason, as I said, for taking the dog in is using meters. The meter's not that accurate. The dogs will pick up parts per billion, whereas the meters will only pick up parts per million at that. Demonstration, but one of these cans is imprinted with one drop of 75% evaporated gasoline. They'll pick up on 18 different ones, but the gasoline is actually what they're imprinted with. When he makes an alert, he'll go to the cans, he'll sit, give eye contact and point with his nose. At that point, then he's rewarded with food. The only time the canine's fed is when he makes an alert. The gasoline does not, there's no side effects to the odor. You know, as far as their cavities or anything, they don't have any problem with it. Whenever he makes an alert, like I said, he'll sit, point his nose, and make eye contact, feed him. When we don't make a fire scene, we'll take the canine out. We have what we call a daisy wheel set up. We'll spin it around. There are four cans on a pivot. We'll spin the cans around, and he'll have to alert which can the drop of gasoline is in before he's fed. As soon as he alerts, then we feed him. He's fed on a daily basis. It's not a situation where he's only fed when he goes and makes a fire, but he's fed every day. Normally we make probably 3 to 4 fires a day with him.
It's a step over it. Look there.
Is it dog treat?
Yeah. Oh, good thing it didn't fall in the can. That's good.
If there's any residual accelerant there, it works on it too. The dog is at no expense to the city. Like I said, it's donated to me and in turn donated to the city. The expense of the training was all the money that went for the training was donated. The city wasn't out any money as far as training. The training was free. The only expense was getting to and from Connecticut for the training, which was done by the state police there. We probably have about $2,500.
With Animal Aid, we'll be the Tulsa Dog Training Club, and that'll start here at 3:30. Thank you.
H mole, M-O-L-L.
has five animals. We'll give him a total bone as well. Five. All right. This will be for the dog crew. Robin Munt.
They look sharp. Huh?
Robin Munt. And looks like she's got.
Girls.
Oh, no.
Where are those cheerleaders? Well, now I want you to notice the difference in the color. You know, OU crimson and red. Well, we're not sure, but so she's taking care of both colors. And look at that wiggle. Well, they're from Tulsi's own most famous Rogers House of Original Design. Aren't they great? Thank you. Boy, thank you. She's on her way to the ball field in her pink team uniform to play in their very first game of the season. And her team, the Great Flying Furballs, the shortstop position. And the coach may change her position to official bench warmer when the first ball comes flying her way between second and third base. And he realizes that Nakia is no retriever. Here she comes.
Jason, sit back.